Welcome to PitStop Pro and PitStop Server version 13 update 1, the latest update of our distinguished PitStop product line. The following video has been designed to give a brief overview of the new features included within this product update, which is a free upgrade to all PitStop 13 users. PitStop Pro version 13 update 1 fully supports the latest release of Mac OS X 10.11, also known as El Capitan, as well as Windows 10. The Macintosh installer will now place the PitStop plugin within an external library directory to ensure that PitStop remains unaffected by future Acrobat updates, whereas previously the application plugin directory was removed upon update, requiring users to reinstall PitStop. While the new features within PitStop Pro version 13 update 1 will be equally available within PitStop Server 13 Update 1, note that speed improvements have been made to PitStop Server by using less disk access when processing multiple files, and PREFLIGHT reports are also now generated faster in this update. This update ships with the latest ICC profiles from FOGRA, FOGRA 51 and 52, which are also available as output intents. You will also notice two new standard device link conversion action lists to convert from the old standard profile to the new profile. Also installed is the new IFRA profile for newspapers. The Add Copied Graphic action list has been expanded to provide the ability to place multiple objects, similar to a step and repeat command, with enhanced distribution and region control. Here, I've added a mailing block to a 3UP postcard in one click. This functionality is also very useful for adding page furniture, such as grommets for large format, sign and display printers, as shown here, and available as a standard action list. The success of an action list or PREFLIGHT restriction can be greatly dependent upon a selected region within a file. PitStop Pro continues to pioneer the most sophisticated approach to selecting objects and regions by introducing the power to select a region based upon an irregular shape, such as a cutter guide or die line. A true first in the marketplace, and extremely practical to the packaging and label printers, as seen in the following example. Here, you can see this document has a variety of potential options to base a PREFLIGHT restriction selection, such as layers, or perhaps the cutter guide or die line. However, for this demonstration, we're going to PREFLIGHT only objects that are within or overlap the content area panels. By selecting the contours which define the live print areas, I can add this precise selection to my PREFLIGHT restrictions so that my PREFLIGHT is now limited to the area of concern, reducing, if not completely eliminating, false positive results in checking non-print related material or areas. And here you see the results of PREFLIGHTing using a contour-based restriction. Note that only objects within or overlapping the defined areas have been checked. Complex vector shapes within a PDF file can introduce a variety of challenges within a workflow, and in some cases even limiting the ability to render or output this information. You can now create either selection or check action lists to check or select pages based on the total number of nodes on a page. The check function can be used to notify a user that a problematic page exists, while the select function could be combined with a replace page content with bitmap to rasterize the complex vector art, ultimately reducing output and preview problems elsewhere in the workflow. The crop image action list has been updated to allow the user to crop away the white pixels of an image, leaving only visible data, which can be beneficial for the purposes of subsequent processing or adjusting, which will now be limited to only visible data. The Select Pages action list has been upgraded to allow users to select pages or page ranges starting from the end of a document. By simply adding an R to the value in the page range field, you can now work backwards from R1, or the last page of the document, to R2, which would be the second to last page of the document, and so on. You can now also choose to select every nth page of a document. Both features can be valuable for the purposes of making page-specific adjustments or for restricting a PreFLIGHT profile. Users can still select spot colors based on a list of spot colors. This list can be created using the Color Picker or Document Spot Colors. Or, you can also copy and paste a list of spot colors to make spot color selections that much easier. To do this previously, you would have needed multiple actions to select each color. The Scale Pages action lists now work in conjunction with variables. And can also accept values with up to 4 decimal places, allowing for a much greater level of precision with reductions or enlargements. When using an action list to select an object, users can now choose to cut or copy a selection to a temporary clipboard. Next, you can easily add a paste action list to then paste this material onto another page or pages. You can copy items to up to 1,000 clipboards if desired, and the user interface is very intuitive with regards to which objects go with which clipboard and how to configure this. This new functionality means that you can cut and paste objects within action lists, which has multiple uses. Here's an example of the functionality in use for making a varnish separation. The Just Make My Office PDF Work, ISO coded V2, is a special PreFLIGHT profile designed to fix office-based sRGB PDF files. It's not so much a checking PreFLIGHT profile as it works on the idea that the file will be incorrect as supplied. It's mainly about fixing it and getting the file in a good state with one click. This PreFLIGHT profile creates a PDFX4 file with live transparency and uses the ISO-coded V2 ICC profile as an output intent, among other things, including ensuring proper knockout and overprint settings, CMYK color conversions, keeping black items to the black channel, configuring page boxes accordingly while extending bleed, adding crop marks, and more. The GWG 2012 Packaging PreFLIGHT Profiles are a new set of PreFLIGHT profiles released this year, specifically for the packaging industry, based on the GWG 2012 PreFLIGHT specification. Thank you for watching, and we hope that you enjoy exploring the new features included within our latest update of PitStop version 13, Update 1.